few day ILS students, parents, teachers, CNU administrators, and everyone else out there who are witnessing this virtual graduation ceremony. I am Mr. Kim Francis Rodriguez, an ILS student teaching mentor and the public information officer of the university. Another challenging year has passed, a year of learning, of giving and taking, of loving and living. Another year full of intellectual brawls, of dreaming and realizing, of doing and succeeding, of fighting and winning. Today we celebrate our students' academic victory, a feat that not even the dreaded COVID-19 pandemic can stop us from celebrating. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Integrated Laboratory School's first ever virtual graduation ceremony in this academic year 2019-2020. Let us all pause and stand for the invocation and the Philippine National Anthem.
Let us pray. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Gracious, loving Father, as we celebrate this joyous occasion with my fellow graduates, friends, family, teachers, and faculty, please bestow on us your blessing. Today will mark the end, the start of another journey. As such, we give our thanks for your guidance. Through you, we were able to overcome hardships and hurdles on our path.
All of these blessings would not have been possible without you. We ask of you to empower us to walk toward futures with you. We also ask for your hand to help us in these times of need.
Protect and heal my brothers and sisters in COVID-19. Please give your blessings and guidance to our dear frontliners who are desperately saving the lives of your people. Father, guide us through this crisis. Through your protection, we can continue to persevere.
I ask all of this in your name. Amen.
All of this in your name. Amen.
Ask all of this in your name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
To welcome us in this celebration of success is a grade 6 student with high honors. Here is Eunice Isabel Soleng.
Dr. Philomena T. Dayagbil, our University President. Dr. Daisy R. Palumpon, our Vice President for Academic Affairs. Dr. Ethel L. Abao, our Dean of the College of Teacher Education. Ms. Gondelina Villarante, our Dean of Student Affairs. Mr. Renan O. L. Pulyada, our Integrated Laboratory School Supervisor. Dr. Jennifer Gonzalez and Mr. William Augusto, our Grade 6 Mentors. Dear teachers, parents, fellow honorees and awardees, welcome to the commencement of Class 2020. For the past 7 years, Cebu Normal University has been my home and the home of the achievers and proud graduating students. It was in 2013 when I and my fellow graduating students started our kindergarten year. I may not be able to recall everything we did, but I cannot forget the whirling laughter and bond of friendship which we started to foster. It was also at that time when our young minds were ably guided by our teachers and mentors to dream and to work hard to achieve the same. Today, Batch 2020 celebrates our success after facing all hardships and struggles, and after showing to the world our tenacity and perseverance. We reminisce the challenges that stood before us, and we savor the victories and achievements that came after it. I still vividly recall how we welcomed the month of March this year. After our third grading examinations, we were preparing for our family day on confirmation when the World Health Organization recognized coronavirus disease or COVID-19 as a pandemic. President Rodrigo Roa Duterte likewise declared our country under a state of public health emergency. Before I could fully understand the concept of meaning of COVID-19 pandemic and state of public health emergency, my parents told me that I will no longer go to school because classes had been suspended. Cebu City, together with cities and provinces in other parts of the country, were placed under an enhanced community quarantine. My initial joy and excitement upon learning that classes had been indefinitely suspended were short-lived. It was slowly replaced with confusion, sadness, and surprisingly, longing not only for schoolwork and my classmates, but for CNU as well, my other home for the past 7 years of my young life. As I had more time in hand, I find myself wondering about what is truly happening now that the world is battling this pandemic. I realize that the world I know is no longer what it used to be. It is now a world where plans are shelved. Only the essentials matter, and health indeed became wealth. Mobility is limited, and a new normal has emerged. Truly, just like a single snap, our lives have changed. Back in January, I was merely looking forward to our graduation in May and anticipating about what my high school life will be. However, with the pandemic, things which we thought were unlikely to happen became a reality. When our classes started in August last year, graduating without having taken our fourth grading examinations or completing the fourth quarter lessons, for that matter, is not only far-fetched, it is unimaginable. But here we are. Still, despite the odds and uncertainties, we are managing to ride the wave of the pandemic. Through the able initiative of the ILS and with unwavering support of our parents, challenges were hurdled to pave the way for our last hurrah as ILS students. We rightly deserve this culminating activity after having toiled for so many years. We are grateful that CNU-ILS is properly sending us off with good memories from our beloved alma mater. In these trying and uncertain times, the wisdom and what Socrates said is most apt and inspiring. The secret of change is to focus all of your energy, not on fighting the old, but building the new. In this regard, allow me to thank the CNU administration for this virtual graduation ceremonies. This is a concrete manifestation of how dedicated our dear alma mater is on building and welcoming the new normal. Allow me also to take this opportunity to say thank you to my family, especially to my daddy and mommy. Thank you for all of your sacrifices. I will not be here today without your unconditional love and constant guidance. To our teachers and mentors, thank you for your tireless dedication and patience, not just in teaching, but in nurturing us. Thank you for imparting knowledge and core values, which we, the graduating class, can always depend upon in our journey through higher education. To my fellow graduates and friends, we end up one glorious chapter of our lives, and a new and more exciting one will begin. I am sure we will experience new adventures, meet new friends, face struggles, and achieve more victories. But let us not forget the friendship and camaraderie that we forged and treasure them forever. Let us all give our promise to our alma mater, the Cebu Normal University, that yes, we will do good. Yes, we will not forget the teachings and learnings you have imparted on us. And yes, we will fulfill our dreams and aspirations. And of course, we should also give thanks to the Lord Almighty for the gift of life, gift of family, and gift of education. We shall continue to pray that He will continuously guard and guide us as we all embark in a new chapter of our students' lives. On behalf of my fellow graduates, allow me to proudly and virtually welcome our guests, school administrators, our teachers, and our mentors, our proud parents, our relatives, and our friends. Today's affair is especially dedicated for all of you. Welcome and enjoy the first ever virtual commencement ceremonies of Cebu Normal University Integrated Laboratory School. Thank you, and once again, good morning.
To present to us the candidates for graduation and completion, here is the hardworking supervisor of the Integrated Laboratory School, Mr. Reynan Elculiada. This will be confirmed by our ever-dynamic SUC President 3, Dr. Filomena T. Dayagbil.
Dr. Filomena T. Dayagbil, SUC President 3 of Cebu Normal University. As supervisor of the Integrated Laboratory School, I am greatly honored to present to you 166 candidates for graduation and completion, 43 from Nursery 2, 65 from Grade 6, and 38 from Grade 10. They have satisfactorily completed the requirements prescribed by their respective curricula under the K-12 program of the Department of Education, thereby requests your honor to confirm them as graduates and completers.
By virtue of the power vested in me by the Board of Regents and upon the recommendation of the Academic Council that you have successfully complied with all the requirements of the basic education curriculum, I, Filomena T. Dayagbil, SUC President 3, hereby confirm you as elementary graduates and junior high school completers with all the rights and privileges thereunto appertaining. Congratulations!
Thank you very much, Mr. Elculiada and Dr. Dayagbil, and congratulations to our graduates and completers. To give the inspirational message is an ILS alumna who has been a source of huge inspiration to a lot of young people today. This is due to her dedication to her craft, which makes her the best at what she does. She's a person of the art of storytelling, whether in poetry or in music. In fact, her composition, Simula ng Dulo, won second place in ABS-CBN's Himig Handog Songwriting Competition Grand Finals in 2019. Ladies and gentlemen, here is CNU's pride, Miss Therese Marie Villarante.
Good day, graduates, parents, teachers, family, and friends. Today, I am honored to celebrate with you not only this wonderful occasion, but all the days that led to this. I celebrate with you, students, your triumph over academic subjects where you thought you would not see the light of a passing mark. I celebrate with you your triumph over the most dreaded examinations, homework, speaking up in class unprepared, and whatever it was that you found most challenging. Like when one of your classmates chased you with a dead cockroach. Or maybe that was just my classmates and I. Public performances, or the frustration when one of your group members did not do their cleaning assignment. I also celebrate with you the generosity of friends when you've run out of paper. I celebrate with you the undeniable support from your loved ones, the unique identifiers you use for your teachers, the comparing of lunch meals, your crush, the ghost stories, and everything you'll miss about Cebu Normal University. I won't take much of your time. There is food to eat, endearing conversations to be had. Perhaps the faint question of, what now, is like a mild clockwork alarm in your head. And of course, let there be the welcoming quiet of your reasons to be proud. So here are some of my truths that I've learned through the years, and will always continue to learn. Dear graduates, hold on to the things that spark a fire in your heart. What are the things that fascinate you? What moves and excites you? There's a list written by society of stereotypical definitions of success. I'm saying yes, it's necessary to sustain yourself, to not starve. But more than the question of pursuing it professionally, whatever it is that brings you peace and joy, whatever it is that fulfills you, it has to be a way of life. That list, it may as well be a box if you live your life based on the standards of others. Don't miss out on yourself, because missing out on oneself, that's the greatest tragedy. So paint, write, sing, dance, cook, garden, teach, heal, build things, live passionately and meaningfully. This is also how you find your life's best education. Education is never limited to the four walls of your classroom. It's finding what you want to keep learning about your whole life, and it might not even relate to an academic subject. It's the beautiful things that take root in your heart, and I hope that you let it grow tall and mighty. I found my best education in telling stories. One lifetime is not enough to learn everything I can about it, to read all the life-altering books, and to listen to all the powerful songs. On blessed days, there's something that Lin-Manuel Miranda, or Sarah Kay, or Neil Gaiman, there's something that they say or do that takes my breath away. And that new thought makes me fuller, not just as an artist, but as a person. I hope that you will always be hungry to learn. I hope that you marvel at the human capacity to create and make a difference. I hope that you allow yourself to be bad at things you actually want to be good at. The only way to be good at something is to allow yourself to do it badly at first. No one ever starts out as an expert. We will flail in the ocean of uncertainty, and self-doubt will hover over us again and again. You will embarrass yourself. You will get hurt. But Victor Hugo said, "There is something more terrible than the hell of suffering. A hell of boredom." When you take risks, when you struggle, that's how you learn. That's how you grow. The most successful people, they're the ones who fail the most too. All my good songs and good poems only existed because of the bad songs and bad poems. Practice kindness to yourself and others. It's a process. And if you're waiting for all your fears to go away before leaping, life will pass you by. Fear will never go away, but fear is manageable. I have panic and anxiety attacks every time I'm about to perform, or even just talking to people, especially online. But it's to be so afraid and overwhelmed, but do it anyway, because you love it so much, because it's worth it, because you can't be without it. Our greatest fears can come from the things that we love most. Do not deprive yourself of an opportunity just because you're afraid. I constantly remind myself that. An opportunity can lead to many more opportunities. When I joined theater in my third year of college, I never expected that I would fall in love with songwriting. Now storytelling and collaboration continues to lead me to the most beautiful places and people. I promise you that your truth, your passion, and hard work will lead you to the most beautiful places and people. Life can be surprising, but not completely. When the choices that you make every day is for the life you want, the life you dream of, a life you can be proud of. Life can be surprising when it gives you more than you ever asked for. Lastly, and most importantly, be kind. Truly listen and see people. value human life. We are not just numbers and statistics. We are individuals. We love and we are loved. So offer the very best of yourself, your voice, your truth, your talents, your knowledge. Offer kindness, compassion, forgiveness, love. These are frightening times, and love is humanity's saving grace. We need your light. Let's take care of each other. Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations to each and every person who made you believe in yourselves more, who supported you, who will always root for you. Today is the turning of a page. Write yourself a masterpiece.
Thank you very much, Ms. Therese Marie Villarante. At this point, to award the medals and certificates, please welcome the advisors of the completers and graduates.
I am proud to present the graduates of Nursery 2 Joy. Anora Jarrett Nikolai T. Eager Beaver Award, Simply Sweet Award, Great Giver Award. Ardemir Jensen Dean D. Peacekeeper Award, Great Giver Award, BCP Award. Belvestra Kian Lawrence P. Happy Helper Award, Good Sport Award, Extra Miler Award. Cabonillas Jordan Nile C. Eager Beaver Award, Golden Heart Award, Tiny Tidy Award. Kapulan Elijah Paul S. Peace Ambassador Award, Buddy Award, Task Champ Award. Gonzaga Angelo Adrian T. Little Leader Award, Gorgeous Kid Award, Prudent Worker Award. Mercado Timothy Emmanuel G. Star Reader Award, Eager Beaver Award, Neat Kid Award. Osorio Emmanuel Dylan R. Star Reader Award, Eager Beaver Award, Good Communicator Award. Olivar Jake Genesis. Public Speaker Award, Eager Beaver Award, Curious Kid Award. Omolon Seth Edric B. Star Reader Award, Public Speaker Award, Happy Helper Award. Pegarido Liam Vincent S. Good Communicator Award, Eager Beaver Award, Friendly Neighbor Award. Piro Jacob Namier D. Cheerful Soul Award, Eager Beaver Award, Brave Soul Award. Alejandria Rian Sky T. Golden Heart Award, Out of Your Shell Award, Star Reader Award. Boholano Jean Arth B. Patience Advocate Award, Golden Heart Award, Artistic Hands Award. Cabarrubias Alexa Daniel L. Tiny Tidy Award, Extra Miler Award, Simply Sweet Award. Esperta Chiara Therese B. Sunshine Award, Miss Congeniality Award, Team Player Award. Gabukan Minya Marie H. Gorgeous Kid Award, Budding Mathematician Award, Peacekeeper Award. Intong Samantha Gabriel T. Graceful Dancer Award, Artistic Hands Award, Tiny Tidy Award. Lagnason Cara Isabel A. Star Reader Award, Word Beaver Award, Eager Beaver Award. Miaga Minya Kendra P. Gorgeous Kid Award, Good Sport Award, Silent Worker Award. Santillan Claire Jaren Q. Friendly Neighbor Award, Cheerful Soul Award, Awesome Artist Award. Toheno Zoya S. Public Speaker Award, Awesome Artist Award, Little Teacher Award. Ibanez Alexis Gabriel P. Patience Advocate Award, Young Dancer Award, Prudent Worker Award. Congratulations! the graduates of Nursery 2 patients. Alo Yuan Zeb R. Public Speaker Award, Eager Beaver Award, Self-Care Star Award, Barbarona Rumijan III S. Tiny Tidy Award, Determined Kid Award, Faith Driver Award, Curvo Marl Axel D. Artistic Hands Award, Eager Beaver Award, Good Communicator Award. Enolpe Marcus Primos R. Public Speaker Award, Sporty Kid Award, Eager Beaver Award, Escorial Kylie Zymeth, Golden Heart Award, Eager Beaver Award, Courteous Kid Award, Layson Zeus Alfonso B. Extra Miler Award, Courteous Kid Award, Peacekeeper Award, Maderazo Alexander Adrian Gabriel P. Awesome Artist Award, Neat Kid Award, Star Reader Award, Moran Kaylan Dwayne G. Enthusiastic Learner Award, Good Sport Award, Brave Soul Award, Tavis Zane Adam L. Star Reader Award, Tiny Tidy Award, Peace Ambassador Award, Atilio Amber Francesca E. Public Speaker Award, Artistic Hands Award, Miss Congeniality Award, Colina Zana Claire R. BCB Award, Curious Kid Award, Tenacious Striver Award, Gamutan Luisa Lean N. Eager Beaver Award, Happy Helper Award, Sparkler Award, Guelos Mary Adelaide B. Courteous Kid Award, Golden Heart Award, Eager Beaver Award, Herrera Mavis Ferrarin R. Good Communicator Award, Eager Beaver Award, Little Teacher Award, Limoran Gabriela Layton A. Courteous Kid Award, Task Champ Award, Simply Sweet Award, Limpag Mirka Louise P. Out of Your Shell Award, Peacekeeper Award, Star Reader Award, Pescadero Ru Erin T. Public Speaker Award, Star Reader Award, Cheerful Soul Award, Sapio Iana Denise F. Patient Striver Award, Extra Miler Award, Golden Heart Award, Trosha Johanna Cassandra T. Silent Worker Award, Golden Heart Award, Artistic Hands Award, Ubod Janelle Rian T. Extra Miler Award, Self-Care Star Award, Peacekeeper Award. Congratulations!
It is my honor to present to you the Grade 6A graduates and academic awardees. Aledo Lestat Santino C. Anlagon Keith Daniel B. Basanias Gerard Ray S. Binion John Nathaniel J. with high honors and best in science. Cabalias Jeff Gabriel O. Canasa Lordy M. Diario Ethan Josh P. with honors. Iskandor Judo J. Gaviola Jasmine Kim O. Haum Justin M. with high honors, best in mathematics and best in Filipino. Luengas Rayo Floyd S. with honors. Paolo Leonard Joaquin D. Ravina Aaron Y. with honors. Ansigera William J. A. Arguedo Vanna Lavrain N. with high honors and best in Araling Panlipunan. Avila Trinity May R. with honors and best in Edukasyong Pantahanan at Pangkabuhayan. Caballero Alexa Frances D. with honors. Kabukos Micaela Ninia B. with honors. Cordova Athena Cristel E. with honors. Diaz de Rivera Hannah B. with honors. Diones Debbie Joanne D. with honors. Godinez Dominic Jerry C. with honors. Gonzaga Franchella Glanis T. with honors. Gonzalez Ava Cadence B. with honors. Enoch Sofia Christine C. Lagat Jerby Lorenzi with honors. Latonio Zaina Francesca C. Marine Jovian Winnet A. with honors. Ocampo Jaya Aliana. Ulalo Lika Nicole L. Paspasan Angeline Jeanette R. Rosales Charmis Dion B. Antorijano Kathleen P. with honors.
The Grade 6 G graduates. Abiliana Lord Eugene G. Abrea Kivrile P. Aguilar Isaiah Carl Zairos M. with honors. Baclayon Carmelo Kiam S. Dino Damien Ezekiel E. Fortuna Dion Avery D. Hiran Sam Michael A. Guyano Chrysler Kane C. Quintanar Shad Gregory A. Lavandero Benjamin Nino B. Lennis Charles Uriel M. Manubag DeAndre Nicholas M. Muninio Andrew Bennett S. with honors. Sabanal Martin J. G. with honors.
Salomon Vin Zedric R. Abakita Brianna Rain S. With honors. Abinur Lay Ayera Faith H. With high honors. Best in English. Aliganga Aryan C. With honors. Arizabal Elena Rev R. With honors. Balanzag Zabriana Isha I. Balinkazag Lois Monique A. De La Serna Leon E. With honors. De La Victoria Therese Margaret M. Garrido Rain Francis. With honors. Gingoyon Alessandra I. With high honors. Guelos Maria Rosendale D. With honors. Labiaga Zelin Kate S. Lion and Lorraine T. With honors. Maceda Isabella Alexi C. With honors. Munasilio Keisha Charity P. Soleng Eunice Isabel L. With high honors. Academic Excellence Awardee. Surigao Trisha Marie A. Congratulations.
The completers.
Alvarez Charles Raymond M. With honors. Batonghinog Joshua Andrew P. With high honors. Best in Science. Best in Filipino. De Los Santos Nicomedes Jr. M. With honors. Diones Dirk John D. With honors. Best in Mathematics. Emia Marcos Antonio N. With honors. Inanoza Lord Danley L. With honors. Flores Paul Jess Mark F. With honors. Gabato Archangelo C. With honors. Gatos Zoe Ocean P. With honors. Lapa Derich Oriel M. Liamido Jonas Olwen P. With honors. Los Roque Justine C. With honors. Opo Kirk Francis C. With honors. Ponce Josh Marie Andre M. With honors. Best in Athletics. Sonpaiko Jomar D. With honors. Leadership Awardee. Tapia Poverilo Keith Noel C. With honors. Anlagan Denise Catherine B. With honors. Asas May Christine C. With honors. Badinas Leon Rain E. with honors. Cabatania EJ Vivian A. with honors. Kagasan Narel S. with honors. Chavez Jana Teresa B. with honors. Cinco Precious Jewel T. with high honors. Best in Technical Vocational Education. Domer Sofia Marie C. with honors. Iskala Kaizen Kenny with honors. Limpag Nicole K.L. with honors. Best in Arts. Lubid Claire M. with honors. Mordeno Nina Marie F. with honors. Best in English. Uyangorin Phoebe Aura B. Pideri Rand Erica Nicole M. with honors. Ries Samantha Kim N. with honors. Rivera Zane Margaret A. with honors. Rolion Shena Cassandra R. with honors. San Diego Nina Marie W. with honors. Sudwesti Precious Diane N. with honors. Tumulak Althea Marie G. with honors. Villamore Trexie M. with honors. Yap Maryvere E. with honors. Best in Social Sciences.
Thank you, advisors, and congratulations once more to our graduates and completers. To deliver the speech of gratitude, please welcome a grade 10 student with high honors, Mr. Joshua Andrew Batonghinog.
It was not so long ago when our journey began. For most of us, we entered the portals of Cebu Normal University Integrated Laboratory School with nothing more than a dream. And today, together we stand as survivors, armed with knowledge, skills, and values to bring this dream closer to reality. To others, this moment may simply be equated as the end of the tunnel or a breath of relief or an exultation over freedom. But after years, under the nurture of our alma mater, we know it is much more than any of these. Life is an open road, and though we've studied its highways and byways, we were never left without a roadmap. Our mentors, student teachers, and parents have constantly been our guide. All paths, all encounters lead here. An ultimate direction, a bend on the road. Our journey in our junior high school life was like a roller coaster ride. Not because we had our fair share of ups and downs, but because of the plus twists we experienced all throughout these years. Who could ever forget the failures and disappointments we encountered along the way? The loves lost and found, the classes and teachers worth remembering, the ridiculous adventures that brought wrinkles to our student teachers and mentors, the jokes we played on each other, the battles that seemed so important to win, the friendly competitions, and the triumphs. We have faced innumerable challenges and surpassed all of them because of our will to succeed. We may have thought of giving up at the middle of stormy days, but our dreams were bigger than our problems. we can easily recover from any mishaps. We stand up after tumbling down into hardships, bringing with us new lessons we've learned. We stand up through challenges stronger than before. Why is that so? Because we see failures as our building blocks towards forming a better version of ourselves. I know that it has been a terrific experience for us here in the ILS, and parting is such sweet sorrow. But the world is beckoning on us, and as much as we would like to stay in the safety and comfort of our alma mater, we must now begin another journey in our life. To begin something new, you must sacrifice something old, because every end has a new beginning. CNU has taught me a lot of lessons, life, and core values that I can proudly manifest wherever I may go. During my 4 years of stay here in the ILS, and looking back to those most precious times, I have grasped the realization that there are countless people who have imparted their efforts to mold and lead me into what I am today. The people whom I am indebted and owed all of my gratitude, and the most cherished things I am truly grateful of. First and foremost, I offer my deepest gratitude to our Almighty Father. Had it not been for Him, I wouldn't be here right now, because He is the one who has given me the strength and courage to press on both academically and spiritually through my high school years, especially in times of discouragement. He has blessed us all and guided us throughout our entire voyage in the CNU-ILS, leading us to the right path to success. I would also like to thank Him for bestowing us with the eminent bounty of education that has been given by our dear proficient teachers, whom He used as instruments to bestow us an immense amount of profound assistance and heartfelt support in this most reputable institution that has led us up to this very moment. I also offer my heartfelt gratitude to our beloved parents and families, the true foundation of who and what we have become. You deserve to share every honor we receive today. I doubt if you would have been able to face all the challenges if it were not for you. If the road to success is filled with people pushing us along, I know that our parents would be at the finish line, encouraging and waiting for us to cross it. Today, we pay tribute to them for being our pillars of strength, for always believing in us when others did not, for indoctrinating us with the virtue that excellence is a habit and not a goal. You have continuously strengthened and inspired us, without which we would have never come to reach this moment. Thank you so much for the laughter, tears, comfort, patience, care, and love. You have all given much to see this day, and we hope that in some way, we have made you proud. On behalf of all the completers, I would love to offer my sincerest gratitude to the student teaching mentors, grade level advisors, school administrators, and to all the school personnel for helping us become the person we never thought we could be. We just don't become competent individuals without a lot of different investments from a lot of people in this prestigious institution. You have taught us how to be self-motivated, active learners, and productive analytical thinkers. We understand we were far from perfect students, and that more than once, we have brought you much pain, frustrations, and even rage. Today, we show you our sincerest gratitude for molding our characters and for showing us that there is still much to learn. Your firm guidance will always be appreciated. For now, realize that like greatness, nothing grows well under the shade of a large tree. You taught us the information to decode life and be able to support ourselves. You gave us the instruments to join the orchestra of the world. We love you, admire you, learn from you, and above all, we salute you for your greatness. I would also like to acknowledge all our student teachers who has always been there in our journey in the CNU-ILS. Thank you for the never-ending support when we were struggling, for the patience when we were annoying, for the care and guidance you have given us every time. You have done more than words can express. Forever into our future, we will tell stories and reminisce of the memorable people that taught us so diligently. We excel in the subjects we love and bake this excellence into our future careers. We may not be able to recognize you all, but rest assured that each and every one of you occupy a special place in our hearts. To my classmates, friends, and colleagues whom I have spent my four cherished years in junior high school, thank you so much for the treasure-worthy experiences, for all the uphill battles we've overcome together, for the efforts each has exerted for the betterment of the class, and for all the merriment, indulgence, and trips that made us take a break from stressful process of education. Thank you for flashing a genuine smile on our face and for not letting us do or face situations alone, for backing us up every time. My dear classmates, this is the moment we have all been waiting for. Everything we've accomplished, everything we've been through, has led us today. Just 4 years ago, we were skinny little freshmen trying to figure out our next class and looking clueless to all the upperclassmen. Now, we are the upperclassmen. We survived the long journey of our junior high school. For some, 4 years seems like a lot, but to us, it seems like it just happened yesterday. I know that the COVID-19 pandemic has indeed thrown a curveball to us all, and we find ourselves in unprecedented times of change and uncertainty. This time in our world means different things to each one of us. For some, it is the loss of a job. For others, the challenge of taking care of or being isolated from family. For those working on the front lines, it means finding the courage to help others while putting themselves at risk. For us, it means having to miss out on an opportunity that we have been looking forward to. But even though there might not be pomp because of our circumstances, never has a graduating class been called to step into the future with more purpose, vision, passion, and energy and hope. This pandemic has already proved that despite all the challenges we have encountered, we continue to thrive and pursue our dreams. Plans grow better during rainy days. Let us not forget the struggles we face and the important lessons in life we learn during our education process, no matter how dark and hurtful the past was. Let us bear in mind that these are our foundation in building a sturdier version of ourselves. This moment is a great manifestation of the hard work, sweat, and tears we have invested in our education. Thank you, Cebu Normal University, our dear alma mater, for the deep-rooted values and knowledge that you have engraved to our whole being, in which we will surely uphold as we step beyond your portals. You have become our home and shall forever remain our lighthouse. It is, and always will be, an honor and joy to have been part of this eminent institution. We will always hail your name with pride and forever give you our loyalty. My dear classmates, and to all completers, let us congratulate each other for overcoming those challenges and for being able to reach this far. Let us not worry ourselves for failing, because it is through failures that we learn better. Failing means having a time to breathe, having a time to rethink things, having a space to grow. It serves as a redirection in our lives. Everyone fails, but not all who fail is a failure. for failures are only for those who did not have the courage to stand up after they fall. We will fail, but we will never give up. Let us always uphold the honor and prestige of CNU wherever we may go, and be exemplars of a true and dignified normalite. Congratulations, everyone. Thank you very much, and a pleasant day to each and every one of us.
Thank you, Joshua. Truly, our being scaffolds to you, our students, is always being made meaningful by your successes. Friends, graduation celebrations are never complete without the anthem that bespeaks every graduate or completer's journey. And to highlight some of their most unforgettable memories, here is One Direction's right now. Please watch this.
Lights go down and the night is calling to me, yeah. I hear voices singing songs in the street, and I know that we won't be going home for so long, but I know that I won't.
In any undertaking, the meaning of success is dependent on who we dedicate them to. For the most part, we return them to the ones who selflessly gave a big part of themselves to us. Our graduates and completers prepared tribute videos to those they consider their heroes in their epic educational battles, their parents, and their teachers. Please watch this.
Dear Mom and Dad, there are no words that can express our gratitude and appreciation for you. We are very lucky and thankful to have amazing parents that have our backs in everything we do. Your never-ending support, countless sacrifices, and unconditional love has made all our achievements we accomplished possible. Have guided us in everything we do and comforted us when we fell to our lowest, raising us up even higher. You have served as our role models to inspire us to become the better versions of ourselves that you see within us. And you have instilled within us lessons, values, and virtues that we will carry forever within our hearts.
Thank you for the gift of friends who know everywhere I've been and loved me back home again. Thank you. And for the ones who let me down and taught me what I know now of forgiveness and the freedom I found. Thank you. Thank you.
To the people who were there for us since day one, to the people who sacrificed everything for our happiness, to the people who made us who we are today, and to the most important people in our lives, thank you. And with all our hearts, we love you.
This song is for those who inspire us today, who always lend a helping hand to help show us the way. This song is for those who see their students through the tough times in their lives. For that we say thank you. You have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have all. silent cries. Who stepped in to wipe the tears from the children's eyes? For those who gave us a safe place to grow, a place for us to call our home forever, we will know that you have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you. This song is for those who taught us right from wrong, who taught us much more than their craft to help our minds grow strong. This song is for those who guide us through and through, so that we can make a life, for that we say thank you. You have made a difference. You have shaped our minds. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything you do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you. I look back on my life and to the path within my reach. I hope I can change the life of those that I teach. I can make a difference. All I do is try to see a different world through the children's eyes. And I will always be there in everything I do. I hope that you're proud of me as I am proud of you. And I will always be there in everything I do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you.
To lead the Pledge of Loyalty is another Grayton student with high honors, Miss Precious Jewel Cinco.
To all the graduates and completers, kindly raise your right hand and repeat after me. The Pledge of Loyalty. With solemn vow of responsibility, I pledge myself to hold on high the lamp of knowledge and the crimson and gold as a sacred trust and emblem of my responsibility and duty. I promise to live a clean life, to be good to the youth and citizens of my alma mater, and to do my best in the battle against ignorance, in the name of God, my country, and my people.
To lead the alumni oath, here is the CNU Federation of Alumni Associations Incorporated representative for ILS, Ms. Maria Milagros del Socorro.
The alumni oath. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. Staunch and undaunted, shall I remain loyal to the Federation of the Alumni Association of Cebu Normal University. Responsibility, duty, service, shall I pledge for the benefit of humankind in my own chosen career, profession, discipline. Shall I be forever bound to do my best? This oath of alumni allegiance, I swear, so help me God. Congratulations, graduates!
Ladies and gentlemen, today will go down in history as the very first virtual graduation ceremony of the Integrated Laboratory School. To all our completers and graduates, their parents, teachers, and family, my biggest and warmest congratulations. Blazing with the flames of crimson and gold, let us all sing with deep fervor the CNU hymn.